Does anyone have anything they'd like to bring up about Manchester High School?
Madam Chair? The only thing I can think of is, I know we got some updates from Dr. Littlefield and forwarded from Manchester, I think it was on, it was a class sizes. Yeah, I didn't know if that's something Dr. Littlefield was prepared to share with the public or not.
I think the issue was that we have received the report. I think what the board needs to discuss is how you want those reports analyzed. Mr. Dubas was doing such a fine job. You know, what are we going to do? Because I think we need to continue analyzing and getting those notices to Manchester.
So, just for the public's knowledge, there were some points of information made. Mr. Dubas, I don't want to classify it as a math nut, but I think he enjoyed math. And he enjoyed crunching numbers, so he had volunteered to crunch the numbers whenever they came in from Manchester. And I mean, I wasn't on the board for it. He used to put them in some type of a format for you guys, is that correct? Yeah. So Dr. Littlefield was looking basically for a transition from Mr. Dubas for somebody else potentially on the board to do that. And I don't want to speak for any of the other board members, but you know, we're all fairly busy with everything going on, jobs, the school board work and so forth. I know I suggested that this would be a good job for the SAU number cruncher, Karen, and I just threw that out there for discussion, so I thought we could discuss that in public. And I didn't know how the board felt about that, if the rest of the board, if somebody else here maybe was a number cruncher, enjoyed doing that work, pick it up from Mr. Dubas, or I know I don't have the time to do it myself. Thank you.
Does anyone else have anything they'd like to say about that?
I'd be willing to do it. I just would ask if anybody knows how to get in touch with Mike Dubas so that I could pick his brain about the best way, or if he already has a format that could easily be used, I'd be more than willing to do that for the board.
Thank you very much, Cheryl. I will check at home. I believe I have a number.
Thank you.
Madam Chair?
Yes.
Under the Manchester High School issues, at the last board meeting, I asked to have a motion to allow me to pick a date for a high school informational meeting. Is this the appropriate time to talk about that, or would you like to wait?
Absolutely.
Okay, thank you. I had made a motion because of urgency that I would like to be able to pick a date and have it approved via email by the board so that I could reserve the room and start making plans to get this in before the end of school, particularly with all the schedules and things that's going on. I worked with the principals and I came up with three different dates, and the board was not polled about those dates. So I have asked Member Liskars if he will declare a meeting with me on June 6th at the Cawley Cafeteria at 6:30 for the purposes of having an informational meeting. I have heard nothing from the board about why the poll wasn't taken or whether you are now supporting this meeting.
Actually, Mr. Pearl, I did poll the board. I asked on the June 5th date, and we could not, there were other commitments. I have. We also began one on the June 6th date, and it was determined that that didn't work because of prior commitments with other meetings. And we could not achieve a quorum of the board to say that a certain date did or did not work. However, if a quorum of the board does not exist, a meeting cannot be called. And I have, spoke to the I had the opportunity today to speak with Diane Garrow, of the, so Leslie and Kidder regarding that there is a meeting posted, that we are having a meeting on June 6th that we did not agree to.
Hey, Madam Chair.
Yeah.
I am surprised when you said we weren't going to surprise.
Yes, I did say.
I emailed you every detail of my plans at every moment.
And when I have addressed what my concerns are, you don't think there are concerns.
And you didn't provide me this to read before the meeting, and you didn't provide it to the rest of the board.
I
listened to your opening comments, and I agree with them. But how do we ever become successful if we don't follow what we agreed to do? So now I need to take a minute and read this.
Please, I received it at 6:25.
Madam Chair?
Yes.
For the record, this is actually the second surprise I received tonight. This one from you. The first surprise was item number 3, chair to address the board. There was no information provided to us about what that was about. So that's been the talk of the town all weekend for myself, trying to figure out what is in this public chair to address the board. People were asking me, they saw the package, they asked, I said, I have no idea. Just want to go on the record, this is the second surprise I received tonight, and we're only partway into the agenda, so you asked us not to surprise each other at the board meetings. This is the second one you've given us.
The first one wasn't a surprise to the board. You received the packet on Friday. It said, chair to address the board.
Madam Chair?
Yes.
On the public email, hsb@sau15.net, you have repeatedly told this board that a single agenda item without any type of description, letting the board know what's coming, you're telling us that wasn't enough information. But now the same rules you seem to not want to apply to yourself. I don't understand what that
means. That is so noted.
Thank you for noting that, Madam Chair.
Madam Chair, according to this document, it says that we need to have 40% of the board to call a meeting.
Yes, but you need a quorum for it to happen.
So, first of all, that allows us to call a meeting. Two people can call a meeting. Can I please finish?
Absolutely.
Two people can call a meeting. Now, my understanding, and I'd like some further information on that, is if a quorum is not made, the meeting can continue as a discussion. And that has happened because you have no way of knowing tonight that we were going to have a quorum. We do not RSVP the board, and you have no way of knowing, yet this meeting is called. If we didn't make quorum, and I have done this on the budget committee before, you can engage in discussion, but you cannot have an action. But you know what? I'd like to forego all of this because the public is asking us not to have these fights. So I would put forth to you the date June 10th, which is the last date that I have submitted. And I would ask the board, let's approve June 10th as an informational meeting, and let's try to do better next time. I make a motion that the board approve a meeting for June 10th at 6:30 in the college cafeteria for the purpose of informational meeting about high school issues.
I'll second that.
Is there any discussion? There being no discussion, we'll take it to a vote. All those in favor of the June 10th high school meeting, please signify by saying aye.
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 No.
No.
Motion fails.
Madam Chair?
Yes.
Will you authorize me to have a conversation with the attorney about this?
I do not authorize anyone to speak with the attorney. That is not in my realm as the chair of the Hooksett School Board.
Dr. Littlefield, will you authorize me to speak to the attorney about this matter? It's my understanding it's my understanding for the public's benefit that there's only two people that can authorize us to expend funds to talk to an attorney, unless the attorney wants to talk to me for free. And that's the chair and the superintendent. So I'm asking both of you to allow me to have a conversation with the attorney.
Actually, I don't speak to the attorney without the superintendent's permission to speak with the attorney.
You have the right to.
I've never exercised that liberty. I do it with full disclosure to Dr. Littlefield.
So I'm asking the question of Dr. Littlefield if he'll authorize me to have a conversation.
And we're giving him the opportunity to think about it.
Yeah.
He knows what he's thinking about. He's a doctor. I have expressed in email what some of my...
Chair, could you let him answer, and this may be the end of the discussion.
I'm giving you time to think about it. Do you need a minute to think about it, or do you want to...
I think I'm going to go home and come back. If you can continue the conversation. I mean, I'm predisposed to be guided by what is right, not who is right. So I'm predisposed to say, yes, my discomfort is a board member asking me permission to do anything. I don't know how to deal with that, because that's sort of like the opposite of what I'm used to. I think the practice has been, and our attorney's practice is, that they won't speak to a board member unless it's authorized by the superintendent. The only thing I would ask Mr. Pearl is that in speaking with the attorney, that you ask for some written whatever to the questions we pose. Not that I don't trust the interpretation, but if it comes from the attorney, it comes from the attorney, and every member of the board can read it and glean from it what they... So I will, unless the board would direct me otherwise, call the attorney tomorrow and let her know, because Grandma Gordon is away, and I'll let you know who it is.
Thank you very much, Dr. Littlefield. And I would just like to comment to the public. The purpose of this meeting was to follow up on the roundtable meeting, which was by many people considered to be very successful and informational to the community. We want to monopolize that and try to get the people to come back and be more involved in the community. I have spent hours and hours trying to get a date approved. And to sit here tonight and have no other dates offered, to have no reasons offered, and to not have the board polled. The board was asked if they could come. You can read all the emails next week, or they're probably there now, and you can decide whether or not you think the board was polled. In my opinion, the board was not polled correctly. I've seen no results of that other than a couple of people saying yes or no. So I'm very disappointed. We have an opportunity here to have one more meeting before school gets out, and I'm being blocked. Thank you.
Yes, Mr. Wiskars, I'll let you go before me, because I was going to speak.
I just had one concern with something you said earlier before your whole discussion with Mr. Pearl. When Mr. Pearl, and to your point earlier about being open and transparent, because you said to Mr. Pearl that you got permission from Superintendent Littlefield to consult the attorney for this information. Can I ask you why you never informed the board of that?
Why I never informed the board of what?
That you were asking Superintendent Littlefield for permission to speak to the attorney about this issue.
It happened very late this afternoon because there was some confusion on when meetings were and weren't, and who was directing the superintendent to do what.
Okay, so this was something that came late today?
Yes.
This wasn't earlier?
Yes. Oh. No, it was very late this afternoon.
Okay, great.
Not, and as has been so noted by many board members, I don't answer from my phone. I may see something on my phone, but I'm not answering because you're getting random things for me from my phone, so I'm sitting at a desktop, and I don't have a 9-to-5 job where I sit at a desk and have computer access. Yes, Mr. Crow.
Madam Chair, did you have a meeting with a lawyer today?
No, I did not have a meeting with a lawyer today.
And in this letter, it says that the board was polled about the 28th and the 6th. The only thing that I saw that resembled a poll was for June 10th. There has been no email poll or phone poll, to my knowledge. I've never been asked about the 28th. And the 6th, I have been told some people couldn't come, but I have not seen a poll. So I think to present to the attorney that you have polled the board and quorum cannot be made is not a correct statement. I would like to see the email or the correspondence that shows that you polled the board and those are the results.
For the 6th, the 5th and the 6th, I asked the board if they were available. On the 6th, I asked you if I wasn't polling properly as a new chair, could you please let me know what your expectation of polling the board was?
Ma'am?
There is record in email that I asked the question. I received email answers from you and Mr. Liskars if you are available or not available. I am aware of Cheryl's, I'm sorry, I'm not gonna butcher that last name, work schedule and that she doesn't have access to email during the day, and I have called her because you can poll a board through calling. I have also communicated to this board that I have asked numerous other people who wish to remain anonymous in this community how a poll is done, because you were not clear what your expectation of polling the board. I thought polling the board meant ask them. I didn't realize you wanted me to call them. You wanted me to send individual emails. I was very clear that I thought I had polled the board.
Madam Chair?
Yes.
As I initially emailed the board and the superintendent, and I said, I'd like to pick a date that we're all available, but it's not necessary that all of us come. And I was very clear about that, but I wanted to pick a date that we were all available. Then you told me that there was some unavailability. That was not a poll, because someone could not be available and still approve to have the meeting. The 28th, so if you want to call the 6th a poll, okay. There is no record of the 28th. There's been no acknowledgement of the 28th.
I believe that I was polled, and I answered, and I completely understood the emails and what was being asked of me, and answered accordingly. The only one was this recent one, June 6th, that I was waiting for this meeting.
I spoke to the attorney on the phone. If something that I said was misinterpreted, that can happen. You have two human beings talking on the telephone about a conversation. I know what I said. I said the meeting on the 28th and the meeting on the 6th. So if we're all being transparent and above board and all playing on the same field, how come we don't have the data from your roundtable?
Madam Chair, before we go into tit for tats and all that.
No, I'm just asking because you want me, because what I have expressed in email, which everyone may not know, is my concerns about having a meeting and not knowing what we're going to talk about is we could be blindsided by questions we don't have answers to. Mm-hmm. And you want us to be prepared and you want us to approve a meeting on faith.
Ma'am?
Absolutely, on faith. Is that what you want me to do, on faith? Mrs. Deja Vu and Her Highness. You want me to have faith?
Madam Chair, please do not assign that name to me as I did not say it. Thank you.
No, but you called me Mrs. Deja Vu, and someone else on this board called me Her Highness.
In a public meeting as a school board member? Let's move on. For the benefit of the
absolutely. The next item on the agenda
Chair,
is the vacant school.
I still have the floor.
No, you don't. I do.
I still have the floor.
No, you don't. Yes, I have not recognized you.
I was recognized. Why are you gabbling me down? You have to give me a reason.
Because you're out of order. We're moving on.
Why am I out of order?
Because you...
What rule have I broke? Please tell me. What I was going to say, Madam Chair, is I'd like to move on and pick a date here so that we can have a meeting. Because that has been my goal. That was the unanimous vote of this board, was to pick a date for a meeting. And I don't really care to fight about this stuff. Let's come up with a date. Do you want to have a meeting?
Yes, when we know what we're talking about.
Madam Chair, if you review the last meeting, I described to you...
I absolutely understand.
And I will refresh your memory.
You don't need to refresh my memory.
That I wanted to discuss the things that were put on the yellow sheet, which you were there and you saw. I wanted to go down through those and give out any information we could about each of those items. And I said, we will have another meeting before the date to discuss the details. That's what we voted on. And in fact, you said you could come to the first meeting if we had childcare. And then everything changed, and now I'm just looking for a date.
Yes, Charles.
My reflection after that meeting and voting yes for it, I started thinking that that might be a little bit early for that to happen yet. I do think that we as a board need to discuss more further those findings and where we might want to go first before we then ask the public to come back in with their input so that we have a better organized idea before we have a meeting with the public.
Yes, Mr. Liskars.
While I appreciate my fellow board member Axton's opinion, when a board makes a decision, they vote on it, they come to agreement. Moving forward, you have to support the will of the board at that time. I understand, Mrs. Axton, you're having reservations about the board decision at that time. Unfortunately, we have to support the will of the board. We made a decision together and we need to move forward. Mr. Pearl is trying to organize a meeting to fulfill the will of the board that night. It seems like a fairly simple operation he's trying to do, and I would agree with him. We feel like, or I should say, I feel like just watching the whole thing, that Mr. Pearl is being stalled. This has been one of the most successful community events I have seen in Hooksett, New Hampshire, in a long time. I personally have received a lot of feedback from the people who attended the roundtable event, from the people who volunteered at the event. Dr. Littlefield and myself witnessed the people there. It was a great engagement of the Hooksett community on a subject that has got a lot of people's attention. So, in my opinion, as a single board member, we made a decision that night. There was an agreement to do an email poll to set up the date, and I believe that's all Mr. Pearl is trying to do right now. And I will not entertain us second-guessing ourselves on our decisions, having rethoughts if we've already come to a decision. We can't do that as a board because we're going to set a very bad precedent. Thank you.
Yes, Mr. Pearl.
To answer Mrs. Atkinson's concerns, at the last meeting, when I was describing what I felt the meeting, how it would take place, I described that a lot of the facilitators, because they couldn't give out any information that night, that was their duty not to, that they felt frustrated because they realized that people sitting at the table had a wrong impression about facts that already exist. I'm not talking about plans. I'm not talking about what we're going to do. I wanted to go through that list and explain any facts that we could. Details of our contract, details of the breach that we have filed, those types of things. What our tuition rate is, those types of things. I made it clear that I only wanted to discuss facts so that people could be more informed. I am and as I had said before, I am not ready to discuss plans as far as what we want to do as a board, and that was not the intent of the meeting, and I think I made that clear at the last meeting. So I would like to go ahead and pick a date, if we can at this point. It's very difficult. I've been asking all three principals so that we don't have any conflicts. It's very narrow between now and the end of school with available dates. But I would like to continue if these dates are unavailable and try for another date. So I would ask to make a motion for the board that I am allowed to work with the principals to find an available date and have that date approved via email by the board.
I'll second that.
Any discussion?
I just have a question, Mr. Pearl. So assuming that you can work with these principals and find a date that is conducive for them as well as this meeting, how would you relay that to both the board as well as the public? What would be your plan?
May I?
Yes.
Well, what I did last time was I contacted the three principals, and at any date when one knocked out, I gave them another date until we found a date that was acceptable or workable for everybody. Then I forwarded that date on to the chair and the rest of the board and asked that that be polled for approval. And that would be the process that I would follow. It is difficult because there could be something going on at Underhill, and we don't want to have it on the night where somebody's got a conflict of which meeting they're going to go to. So that's how I would do it.
Motion on the floor and a second. Do we have any discussion, any other discussion on this motion? With there being no other discussion, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
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 All those opposed say nay.
Nay.
Nay. Mr. Pearl, I understand that you did a great deal of work on our Hooksett.
Madam Chair, what's the motion on the floor now?
There isn't a motion on the floor. I'm just
speaking. We're done.
No, actually, Mr. Pearl, I, the chair, decide when a discussion is done. And I am trying to communicate with you what my reservations are and try to come to a constructive end. I had reservations. You don't want to.
Perhaps you should read Robert's rules to start a discussion. We have to have a motion and a second, and then we start discussion. You voted, Madam Chair. You voted twice.
I would like to make a motion that Mr. Pearl provide to the Hooksett School Board the results of the high school roundtable discussion that was posted yesterday at 1:12 p.m. on the Hooksett Issues blog, so that this board can look at what the community actually said at the meeting. Because, and I'll speak to my motion if I receive a second.
Second.
Okay, absolutely. I would like to make a motion that Mr. Pearl provide to the Hooksett School Board the information regarding the Hooksett, regarding the high school roundtable discussion on April 22nd that he posted yesterday at 1:12 p.m. on the Hooksett Issues blog.
Yesterday
on Hooksett at 1:12 p.m. on the Hooksett Issues blog. Mr. Pearl, did you second it?
Yes, I did.
In reading through some of these, and no, I have not read through all of them. I did attend the meeting, which has not clearly been stated on social media, blogs, and newspapers, that Mrs. Axton and I were in attendance with our children taking advantage of the child care. I have read through these, and not all of them, but a fair amount, and there are some misconceptions in our community. And I would like to go forward with another high school roundtable. I just have some reservations regarding that the board hasn't had the privilege of reading this unless you're on Hooksett Issues. And for us to be in agreement, what are truths and aren't truths, what we can say and what we can't say, before we get in a situation where we look unprepared, because frankly, not having this information provided to me as a school board member who was in attendance at a school board event makes me look unprepared. Makes it look like we're a bunch of clowns at the circus. Mr. Liscars.
Madam Chair, first of all, for the record, I would never want to be considered a clown at a circus. So if you want to talk to the public about that, that's fine, but please don't include the entire board. Second of all, I'm listening to this and I'm thinking maybe this is just an information problem. My understanding of what Mr. Pearl described at the last meeting when we took a vote is twofold. He's trying to arrange something for the public before the end of the school year to keep the continuity of the high school discussion going and put some finality to it, some closure for the parents and the people that actually gave input. My interpretation of what Mr. Pearl was going to do that he described at the last meeting is he was going to put up the large yellow banner that the Becky, can't think of her name right now, the moderator, Becky Burke, took from all of the input that came, that we now have digitized, and she took
that. Please state for the record, we do not have Hooksett Issues has. We, the Hooksett School Board, are not in receipt of that.
Madam Chair, that clarified point of information. The yellow banner is not posted. Those are documents from the individual pieces. I apologize for not posting. I have not received an email from you since Thursday afternoon. I did not even think to email you, and I do apologize, and obviously you've got them. What I described was putting up the yellow banner and us looking at it and talking about what we could talk about. That's what I said. These were just, we had volunteers that went up to the library one night and volunteered to type all that information in because Ms. Burke, when she did the meeting, she said, I don't want to throw away anything. And I have all these papers at my house. So we are volunteers to type all that information in. I am in no way trying to hide that from you. It is not in any order. It is just categorized by the subjects. So the idea is to look at the yellow sheet, talk about what we can, the facts, for the public's advantage, because we understand there's some misunderstandings.
If I could just continue. Thank you, Mr. Pearl. And I agree. If there are misconceptions in the public, and we as a board can't even get a meeting together by the end of the year, it's going to be seen as a very disappointing to the people that participated. I think Mr. Pearl's idea is a good one. With the data that we have, whether it's contracts or tuition rates, what we have is fact. Any of the misconceptions that are on the yellow sheet can be presented at that time. This board has not made any decisions on future plans. That's future discussions for this board. But I really do think it is important to bring finality to this roundtable discussion event. If this gets dragged out till the fall, there's going to be a huge disappointment in this community. I think we can avoid that, really, pretty simply, too, and have a final session as a completion of that whole event that we started with the community. So. I mean, that was my impression of this whole thing, and I thought it was a good idea, and it seemed like the board was in agreement at the last meeting. So that's just my input.
The motion that's on the floor. The motion on the floor is for Mr. Pearl to provide the information that was posted on Hooksett Issues to the board.
I'm sorry, I'm not aware. What is the information Mr. Pearl has posted on Hooksett Issues?
Mr. Pearl, I apologize, it's on recycled paper. It's basically sped page one, what was put on the first sped table. This is there's no real explanation. And then what's on the sped second and third table. And there's duplicates.
It's all the stuff you typed in, John. At the library that night.
From the single pages that everybody put in?
Yes, I took them all and made them into PDFs and categorized them and gave them page numbers. And inadvertently, I'm sorry that I didn't include the school board. There's no desire for me to keep that information from you. I'd like everybody to read that information. But what I'd like to do is have a meeting for this community so that we can actually become part of this community and serve it instead of sit up here like a bunch of fools. Yes, I'm getting awful sick of it.
Mr. Pearl, if you don't mind. Mm-hmm. Just for the record, I just want to state myself, I'm not a fool. And
I'm sorry, Mr. Lestrade. I apologize to the rest of the board.
Thank you, Mr. Pearl.
Mr. Pearl, if it was truly not your intention or you truly an oversight on your part that you didn't share this information with the board, I'm willing to withdraw my first and my second if you could provide this information to the board.
I'll gladly provide it.
Thank you. I'm not... I withdrew the motion.
I'll withdraw the second. I would just like to say, as we leave this discussion, we have no plans for a meeting. Is that correct?
I didn't say we were leaving it.
I've made my motions.
Madam Chair?
Yes, sorry.
I'd like to make a motion to allow myself to poll the principals of the three schools to see if we might have a date available for the community to have a final roundtable event to go over the yellow banner as we talked about at the last meeting. Ideally, it would be nice to have even the information that we're describing here on the table up and available on our website, if that's possible. I would have to have input from Dr. Littlefield on that one, if his staff would be available to do that. If not, I would offer to put it up on a temporary website so people could have access to it.
Excuse me, Mr. Lestrade, I think you're rambling in motion right now.
Am I rambling in motion? I apologize. Stop typing. Let me try to shorten that up. You are correct. I'd like to make a motion to give myself, Mr. Liskar's permission to poll the three principals for an available date to finalize the roundtable discussion event.
Well, I will second that motion for discussion. Chair, I'd like to amend that motion to also allow I would like to amend that motion to direct Mr. Liskars to forward that information to the chair of the board and have her poll the school board for approval of that date.
I'll second that amendment.
Is there any discussion on the amendment? All those in favor of the amendment signify by saying aye.
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 This was a vote on
the amendment.
Plus what? 3-1?
3-1. Is there any more discussion on the motion? I'm just looking at my calendar for a moment. There being no further discussion, if there isn't any more discussion, does anyone have anything else? I'm making sure. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Nay.
Nay.
Madam Chair,
was that 2-2?
2-2.
2-2, it failed. I would like to make a motion that the Hooksett School Board supports the idea of having an informational meeting with the public about high school issues.
I'll second that.
And the reason I made that motion is because at first I thought this was an issue of a date. But now I'm starting to think that it's not an issue of a date and that we don't want to have a public meeting about high school issues. So I'd like to find that out because it's kind of frivolous to keep jockeying around here about dates when, if it's the will of the board, it's to not have a meeting like that.
So the motion is that the school board support the notion of having a meeting on high school issues? Is that
correct?
Yes, Mr. Musgrove.
Didn't we already vote at the last meeting? Did that include, do we have that motion anywhere?
It would be in your packet. On the minutes.
Was it on May 7th?
That was, yes. That was May 7th, yes. I mean, my only point here is if we've already voted in the affirmative of approval of the idea, I don't see why we would have a redundant vote.
Can I speak to that, John?
Sure.
I thought that that meant we should find a date and that people wanted to actually have a meeting on that date. But it seems now that it's not the date that's the issue, it's the underlying whether we're going to have a meeting or not. And that surprises me because we had a unanimous vote and a lot of positive discussion about this meeting. And I thought, even up to today, that this was just an issue of trying to wrangle a date around that people couldn't make. You know, so I guess we should just get to the heart of it. If the board didn't want to have a meeting, then there's no sense in talking about more dates and me asking the principals or you asking the principals, because why?
That's fair.
Do you want me to read the motion?
If you don't mind.
It was on May 7th. Manchester High School Issues. David Pearl, motion to schedule a high school information meeting and a date to be selected and confirmed via email, the purpose to share information with the public on high school information in Hooksett. That was voted 4-0 and carried.
I have expressed what my concerns are about having a meeting without a plan. Without a plan, without knowing. Like, it's great to say all those yellow things up on the wall are what people said. I didn't have the opportunity leaving at 11 o'clock at night to go up and read what everyone said. I mean, this hasn't been provided to the board, but you want us to schedule a meeting to discuss what the public has as misconceptions. I honestly walked around the room at that meeting and tried so hard not to engage in anything, not even small talk, because I didn't want anyone to think that I was trying to stifle discussion. So I'm after the meeting, and yes, I did make that vote, I'm saying I have concern about what we're going to talk about. Yes, Mr. Pearl.
Madam Chair, the discussion on May 7th was that we picked the date, and then at this meeting, which was scheduled to be between any date that I was going to pick, we would have that opportunity. And I can tell you that I totally intend to make the yellow thing public, and if anybody wants to come and help me type, because it's a huge task. This took 2 hours to get to where we are now. We probably have another 2 hours with multiple people typing that thing in. My plan for the meeting was that as all school board members being there, and Dr. Littlefield chose to come, if the idea of how much does a new high school cost? Well, we can look it right up on the internet because we have a very nice report that was done by the high school committee. If there's questions about how many students we have attending different high schools, we have all of that information that we can share. I'm not trying to put anybody on the spot. This is not a quiz show. I intended for us to work together. There's certainly things that some of us know more about the facts than others. And I thought, as we did at the high school roundtable, we could work together and answer those. It's not, and there'll be many that we can't answer. But this is not about putting anybody on the spot. This is about providing information to those people particularly that we realize have some real misconceptions about the facts that are already here in Hooksett.
Mr. Liskars, your motion on the, is on the floor if we are, it's Mr. Pearl's motion, I'm sorry, and you seconded, regarding if we're in favor of a meeting.
Is that the motion we currently have on the floor?
The motion that the school board support the notion of having a meeting on high school issues.
Is there any discussion on that motion? Okay, with there being no discussion, could we please call it, I'm going to call it to a vote. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Mr. Pearl.
Madam Chair, I'm going to default to the board here because I have made every suggestion that I can think of. The board has just said that it's in favor of this, so I'm going to defer to someone else to come up with an idea. Because I think I've run out.
Madam Chair, to Mr. Pearl's point, I've been in support, I think, of every meeting Davey's had. I've been in support of this idea from conception. I want to see it finalized. So I will defer to the two that voted against it each time. The two of you, I'll entertain what you have for ideas right now. Thank you.
I've already stated I think we need to meet ourselves about this, probably in length, and unfortunately we really can never get into anything in length because of the agenda. However, I would like to, I think that this is an important issue, but I do think that we need to be better prepared before we have a meeting with the public again. This way it is productive, and it's productive on our part.
Yes, Mr. Liskars.
So, fellow board member Axton, are you going to make a motion that we can vote on?
No, I'm not.
At this point, I'm really concerned if people don't have a basic knowledge of the high school issues in Hooksett and they're sitting on this board. It's all we've been talking about for the last year. I said we could share. Nobody has to be able to come up with a figure right off the top of their head. We have databases. We have professionals. That's what people are paid for. That's why we're elected. So we can make this happen. To say that we have to plan and we have to do this in length, that means it's not going to happen before school gets out. So why don't we just say that and let's move on, and then it's the summer and start all over.
Mr. Pearl, I understand your frustration, but please understand my frustration yesterday afternoon when 9 different members of the community called me to ask me if I knew about this information. This is the information that I got off the Hooksett Issues website regarding what people have volunteered to type. I'm speaking. And I don't know anything about it. I don't have any of this information, and I understand that you apologize. I have not had an opportunity to look at it. I don't know what people's misconceptions are. I understand there are misconceptions in the community, and what Mrs. Axton is saying is maybe we need to look at that. Maybe if you could provide this to us this evening or tomorrow morning, we have a workshop meeting. We could amend part of our agenda to go over this and discuss it. And at the end of that meeting, we may be able to pick a date because Cheryl and I may be more comfortable with the discussion points. Mr. Liskars has said he typed some of this. Thank you for volunteering your time to type. He has the opportunity to see what some of the misconceptions are. I have not. I was not afforded that opportunity. Mr. Liskars had his hand up.
Actually, yeah, Mr. Pearl, you had your hand up before mine.
You're referring
to the chair recognizes Mr. Liskars.
Thank you, Madam Chair.
You're welcome, Mr. Liskars.
To your point, I am a good typist. I can type real fast. I couldn't tell you what's on any one of those sheets right now, only because the job we were asked to do, myself and some other volunteers that volunteered their time, once again, we have volunteers of the community now participating in this event. This is not just the school board. We had a lot of great volunteers. All we did is we transferred it from paper to digital form, so eventually this information could get up for the public, so they would feel like their input was very important. We didn't want to lose any of the lines that were written on the paper, and that was the only purpose. So even if we had a meeting, I could read those papers right there till the cow comes home, and I'm not going to be able to share anything about it. Those are the public's input. They just wrote down their thoughts, their ideas, and that night, the moderator took their ideas and compiled them into the ones that seemed to be common, hitting home with most of the residents, and put them on a big yellow paper. That's all. This is just the raw data. It's pretty boring, actually. I don't think many people are going to be too interested, but you know what? There may be one resident who feels like they want to see their input, make sure it's counted. And that was, you know, to Mr. Pearl's point, that was the reason he did that, to make sure every citizen felt like they had a voice in this town. And I think that's all we're trying to do here, is continue and finalize this to allow the public to come in one last time, take a look at the big yellow sheet, talk about the points that they made that made it up to that sheet. And then if we had any data, like a contract or something that we already know is concrete, we could share that with them. But if we don't have it, we just say, we don't have it. We're going to be working on that for you folks, but we don't have it right now. But that's all they want. They want some finality to the process that they participated in. Thank you.
Madam Chair, that data is not part of the meeting. That data was just provided. Part of the meeting, as I described it, was to take the yellow sheet, which was summarized by Mrs. Burke in real time from those sheets, and to look at it and comment on what we could. To tell you the truth, I would rather not look at the yellow sheet and get right up there and just talk about what we can talk about, because we're public servants here. We should answer people's questions. They don't expect us to know every answer, but they do expect us to try. This is a note. This document, I don't know if this is even would appear at the meeting, because it is exactly that. It's a lot of raw data. And a lot of the reason I did that was because Mrs. Burke asked me to, after the countless hours that she put in and the other volunteers, so I did. But to turn it around and try to make it like I'm not sharing and this is a good reason not to have a meeting, please. It just insults the people that put all their time in.
Then I think that this can be done at a regularly scheduled meeting, and we could probably adjust the agenda to allow for more public input at that time. Not so sure then that we need necessarily a separate meeting, especially since I'm not available on those dates. I think that this is an important meeting that I attend. I think that maybe the compromise would be to have this at a regularly scheduled meeting and adjust the agenda for it, and adjust if we want for the public to be able to input. This way, where June is very tricky for our administration, for ourselves, I know June for me is an extremely busy month, might be a good compromise.
If we all remember back to our meeting where we had the math presentation and it went on for a long time, and that was a great presentation, the problem with our meetings right now, we have so many backed up agenda items, it's not funny. So adding something of this size that I believe would take hours to get the public's input on and have a discussion would not be an efficient use of a meeting. We're already so backlogged. We must be two meetings behind right now. And the more of this kind of stuff we do, the further it gets backlogged. So I disagree. I don't think it's a compromise at all. I think it's a kind of a meeting we have to have separately, because it's going to take a significant amount of time.
Yes, Mr. Paul.
The other reason that I believe this needs to be a separate meeting is the whole form of this is not a school board meeting. If anybody went to the round table, you'd see that it was far from a school board meeting. The whole idea was to make people comfortable and have conversation, things that we can't accommodate in a school board meeting because we have to have order. So we were able to get a lot of input there that we can't get at public input here. And we were able to react to it in an informal way. And that's really what I'm planning, if we can pull this off, is that people could feel free to talk and we could have some back and forth and talk about some of these issues and not have it be a formal meeting. You know, I'm more than willing to put together a plan, and that's what I was planning on trying to tell you what this was going to be about. But I can't get a date approved. And if we don't approve a date now, forget it. Because the dates are just going too fast. We're already past June 10th, that whole week is gone. So, you know, we're into the next week. There's no, you know, if I was going to be absent and you wanted to have this meeting, I'd have no problem approving it. If one person has to be absent, I don't think that's a problem. Nothing nefarious went on at the round table. We're not going to be voting. We're not going to be doing anything like that. But I don't think we have any trust left in this board, even when it comes to information for the public.
Yes, Mr. Lusgar.
So I have a suggestion, maybe, and we can move on with this, is maybe it's so informal, it doesn't require board input. Maybe just throw this out to the public, and you can have Becky Burke consider with some of the other volunteers to take the yellow sheet and just go over it and talk about it. And at least finality, I think, is the key here. I think finality before the end of the school year is key. So these people feel like their voices were heard and their opinions were respected. That's all I want to see from this whole thing. Thank you.
Yes, Mr. Frank.
I will say here, I am not going to act without school board endorsement, because the data that came from that meeting was from a school board endorsed meeting. So I don't feel it's right for me, although I've thought about it, to just say, I want to have a meeting. I think it needs to be the school board, because that's what the original one was. We were all included in that. And, you know, it's probably one of the only positives that I've really seen in the last, this calendar year since I've been on the school board. And it was a nice feeling to have the public thank us for a change. And there's no effort here to do that, then let's move on.
Thank you,